गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो इन दिस टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 5 मिसलिनियस एक्सरसाइज. इन दैट फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज टू इवैल्यूएट I रेज टू 18 प्लस 1 बाय I रेज टू 25 होल पावर 3. राइट, दिस इज द क्वेश्चन एंड इट इज गिवन दैट वी हैव टू इवैल्यूएट एंड वी नो दैट I the whole square has a value minus 1. So here I can write 4 into 4 plus 2 plus 1 upon I multiply and divide by its I term whole raised to 25 raised to 3. So we get 1 into minus 1 plus I raised to 25 I square is minus 1. So here I'll write minus 1 raised to 25 the whole power 3. So minus 1 minus I raised to 25 whole power 3. That we can split it as minus 1 is as it is and 25 we can write I raised to 4 plus 6 plus 1 raised to 3. So minus 1 minus I raised to 4 raised to 6 into I raised to 3, right? That is minus 1 minus minus 2 the whole square raised to 6 is minus I into 3. Now here you can take the minus sign common. So minus 1 raised to 3 into 1 plus I the whole power 3 expanded using the formula A plus B the whole square. So we get 1 plus 3I plus 3I square plus I cube is minus 1 plus 3i minus 3 minus I, that is minus of minus 2 plus 2i is equal to 2 into 1 minus I. Right? So this is your answer. The next question is for a 2 complex number. So the next question is for a 2 complex number z1 and z2, prove that real part of z1 z2 equal to real part of z1 into real part of z2 minus imaginary part of z1 into imaginary part of z2. So first we'll consider z1 equal to x1 plus I y1 and z2 is x2 plus I y2. Right? So now if you see on the RHS part, it is z1 z2. So first we'll multiply z1 z2 and when we do the multiplication we get x1 plus I y1 into x2 plus I y2 is equal to x1 x2 minus y1 y2 plus I into y2 x1 plus x2 y1. Now we'll take the real part as on the RHS side we have to get the real part. So real part is a term which is without I, that is this is your real part x1 x2 minus y1 y2. So this will take as a equation number 1. Now see the RHS part, it is real part of Z1. So real part of Z1 is X1, right? Real part of Z2 is X2. Multiply these two. So real part of Z1, real part of Z2 is X1, X2. Now we'll find imaginary part of Z1. Imaginary part of Z1 is what? It is Y1. And imaginary part of Z2 is what? It is Y2. Again you multiply these two. So imaginary part of Z1 into imaginary part of Z2 is Y1, Y2. Right? So this will be our equation number 2. And on the RHS side here it is a minus sign. So we'll subtract this 3. This is our 2 equation and this is 3. 2 minus 3. So we get real part of Z1, real part of Z2 minus imaginary part of Z1, imaginary part of Z2 is X1, X2 minus Y1, Y2, fourth number. So you can see that this fourth and equation 1, they have a same value. So we can, it is proved that real part of Z1, Z2 is equal to real part of Z1 into real part of Z2 minus imaginary part of Z1 into imaginary part of Z2, hence proved. Next question is, if x minus iy equal to under root of a minus ib upon c minus id, prove that x square plus y square the whole square is equal to a square plus b square upon c square plus d square. So we can solve this question by taking a square root on both the sides. Given part is x minus iy equal to under root of a minus ib upon c minus id. Now what we'll do, we'll take a square on both the sides. So taking square on both the sides, so we get x minus iy the whole square is equal to a minus ib upon c minus id. Now taking modulus on both the sides, taking modulus we get modulus of x minus iy the whole square is equal to modulus of a minus ib upon c minus id. And we know the property of modulus is what? It is under root of x square plus minus y the whole square plus under root of a square plus b square. Here it is a equal to sign under root of c square plus d square. Right? Now, so x square plus y square is equal to, we'll take a square on both the sides so that this root is cancelled and we get a square plus b square upon c square plus d square. Right? Hence proved. Next question is to convert the polar form. The question is 1 plus 7i upon 2 minus I the whole square. So we'll take let z equal to 1 plus 7i upon 2 minus I the whole square. So expand it. So we get 1 plus 7i. Denominator expansion will give 4 minus 4i minus 1, which is equal to 1 plus 7i upon 3 minus 4i. Take the conjugate of 3 minus 4i. So 3 plus 4i. Right? Next step is to multiply. When we'll multiply 1 plus 7i into 3 plus 4i, we get 3 plus 25i minus 28 upon 9 plus 16. That is minus 25 plus 25i upon 25. Dividing by 25, we get minus 1 plus I. So z equal to minus 1 plus I we got. And when we compare this with I x plus iy, we get the value of x as minus 1, y as 1. Right? So we next step is to find the r modulus is under root of x square plus y square, x square, that is minus 1 the whole square plus 1 is 2. And tan alpha is what? It is imaginary part of z upon real part of z. Right? So imaginary part of z is 1 upon minus 1 is 1, which implies alpha equal to pi by 4. Right? So argument of z is theta equal to pi minus alpha. Why? Because z is lying in the second quadrant. As you can see that x is less than 1 and y is greater than 0. That means it is in the second quadrant. And for second quadrant it is theta pi minus alpha equal to pi minus pi by 4, which is equal to 3 pi by 4. So the polar representation of a complex number is of the form r into cos theta plus I sin theta, right? So what is r? It is under root of 2. Cos 3 pi by 4 plus I into sin 3 pi by 4. So this is the polar representation and the answer is root 2 cos 3 pi by 4 plus I sin 3 pi by 4. Now the next question is to find the real number x and y if x minus iy into 3 plus 5i is the conjugate of minus 6 minus 24i. So first z equal to x minus iy into 3 plus 5i. Multiply. So we get 3x plus 5xi minus 3yi minus 5i square, which is equal to 3x plus I into 5x minus 3y plus 5i. And we will write in the form of real part and imaginary part. So we get 3x plus 5i plus I into 5x minus 3y. Right, and by the fraction the z is the conjugate complex of a minus 6 minus 24i. So z is equal to minus 6 plus 24i, right? The conjugate of this minus 6 minus 24i is minus 6 plus 24i. So we'll write 3x plus 5i plus I into 5x minus 3y is equal to minus 6 plus 24i. Comparing the real part and the imaginary part on both the sides, we get a two linear equation of the form 3x plus 5y equal to minus 6 and 5x minus 3y equal to 24. So use the elimination method and solve. So we get 15 plus 24y minus 30 and 15x minus 9y equal to 72. Change the sign. So we get minus plus minus 34y equal to minus 102. So y equal to minus 3. So substitute that value of y and in the equation 3x plus 5 into minus 3 equal to minus 6. So 3x equal to 15 minus 6. 3x equal to 9. X equal to 3. So x equal to 3 and y equal to minus 3 is the solution. Right? Now the next question is, if alpha and beta are the different complex number and modulus of beta equal to 1, find beta minus alpha upon 1 minus alpha bar into beta. So here it is given that beta minus alpha upon 1 minus alpha bar into beta. Multiplying the denominator and numerator by beta bar. Multiply numerator and denominator by beta bar. So we get beta minus alpha into beta bar upon 1 minus alpha bar beta into beta bar. So beta minus alpha into beta bar upon beta minus alpha bar into beta bar. So we get modulus of alpha beta into beta bar upon beta bar minus alpha bar into beta bar the whole square. So that we will take as a common into beta bar. So we get next step is beta minus alpha upon beta bar minus alpha bar. And we here will use a property that beta minus alpha the whole bar. Okay? But the value is 1. Right? Now the next question is to find the number of a non-zero integral solution of 1 minus I raised to x equal to 2 raised to x. Right? So here we'll first get the modulus of z is 1 minus I is under root of 1 plus 1 is root 2. So root 2 raised to x is 2 raised to x. Right? So I can write root 2 raised to x equal to, or we can write this 2 as x by 2 equal to 2 raised to x. Base same, so we can equate the powers. So x is equal to 2x, x into 1 minus 2 equal to 0. So x minus 1 equal to 0. So x equal to 0. So here you have to complete your miscellaneous exercise in your fair book.